guys, today on Pets in a Pawd, we're going to be putting together an enclosure for an Ackie monitor. So today we're in another weird position with tank building. I am laying on the ground. If I were to sit up, I'd be out of frame, but I will get out of frame for just a second to show you part of the enclosure we're gonna be working with. So this is our enclosure that I've been working on to finish the background. This is going to be for an Ackie monitor, also known as a ridge tail monitor, spiny tail monitor, or I believe the scientific name is Varanus acanthurus. And so this enclosure is 5 feet long and 2 feet high by 2 feet deep. So it is a little bigger than the minimum 4x2x2. It has an extra foot of space, floor space, which is preferred because these are mostly ground dwelling, although they are known for climbing, which is also why I've been working on a nicely textured background with nice big ledges. There's 4 bigger ledges, and then the background itself, like I said, is really rocky. There's some deep grip space within the rocks. If you want to know how I made the background, it is hard. It's a hard background with a lot of grit to it. You can watch my leopard gecko DIY background there. It's the same steps. I did the same things. All I did was do a different color. So you could watch that video, and I will link it below if you want to know how I made this background. And so today what we're going to be left with is just putting in the soil and setting up kind of the different features within here. I don't have my monitor yet, so I am doing this with plenty of time ahead, so that way when it does arrive, this is all set up. So what we're gonna be doing is mixing children's play sand, which is safe for reptiles and really cheap. That is a 50-pound bag that was $5. So it's a lot cheaper than buying reptile branded sand. I just got that at Lowe's, and again, it costs $5. And so we're gonna mix a 30% sand mixture with 70% topsoil. And so the topsoil out of frame right here, again, kind of cheap. It's a same price as most soils, but the soil in specific should be topsoil, organic with no fertilizers. And so that's what I bought. So here's our sand, and it's actually fun to play with as is, because it is play sand. So it's meant for like children's sandboxes, but your Ackie doesn't want just sand. So again, that's only 30%. You should have 70% of soil. So what I think is what the ratio works out to is you have one of those bags of sand and 2 large bags of soil. That's the right ratio, at least for a tank this size. Okay, so let's mix this before deciding what more we need to add in. That was actually a lot of work carrying all these big bags back and forth, and even mixing this took some effort. So what you're seeing here inside is that 30 to 70 sand to soil mixture. I did add a secret ingredient, and that is excavator clay. So what this is it's different than sand in that it is clay. And so this is more native to Australia, what the Ackie will be kind of inherently used to, even though it's never been to Australia. And excavator clay holds burrows and tunnels very well. So I did mix in maybe about like another 10%. I know that now that's over 100, but like 10% just to give it some substance. When the Ackie is burrowing, this will help kind of hold it into place. Also, notice the soil that I had in the bags did have a lot of moisture in it. So you might see some condensation happening down in the corner. And what that can actually cause is, as this top layer dries out, it will still be moist down here, and that can cause mold outbreaks. So what we're gonna do is stop here today. We will add the decorations in a couple seconds for you guys, but I'm gonna add the decorations in after a couple days to allow this time to dry out. So what I'm gonna do is 3 times a day, probably I'm gonna come in here and I'm just gonna mix all the soil up, and that will just encourage, you know, aeration and drying of everything in all layers. As well as today, I am gonna add the spring tails in so that way they can control the mold as it's possibly going to outbreak. And even when I do mix the soil, it's not gonna harm the spring tails. So we will come back soon to add in the decor, like the basking spot, and I do have a really neat idea as far as a deep hide goes, because we'll also talk about heights and depth of substrate that you need to have for an Ackie. Guys, I'm back, and more than one thing has changed since I last saw you. Yes, my hair did a complete 180 in the time between that. So I want to clarify a couple things. When I last left the video, I said I wanted to let the soil dry out, and I want to clarify that when you have your Ackie, you want the soil to be moist. You actually want it to be probably a little more moist than this. See how it's just crumbling? And that's what you want it at, but the Ackie's not here yet. And part of the thing is when the Ackie's in here, it will be burrowing and going through all the sand, which means it's constantly mixing it and keeping airflow through it, which cuts down on mold. But since the Ackie's not in here, if I were to just throw the soil in, let it be moist and kind of like sit there, it could possibly mold. So what I did was I added springtails so that they're in there, you know, eating all the nasty stuff that's gonna potentially grow. And I was mixing it by hand every once in a while. So what we're gonna do first is I have, you can kind of see right here, these cork pieces. I have this bad boy. This is a huge cork piece I spent some good money on. But I love this piece because it sits flat on the ground. The bottom of it's flat. And the top, it's just this huge opening. It's a huge, huge tube. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna wedge this all the way down in the soil and then fill this to pretty much to the top with soil. And this will kind of become a moist hide. I have a second log that's very similar to this that I'll also butt up against it. And so these will be where you have that really deep substrate. So this is gonna be basically a naturalistic moist hide, so without using tubs and stuff like that. And so I have this second big cork piece, again with the front opening and then flat on the bottom, that I'm going to essentially put kind of next to where that area is so the Ackie can exit out of that tube behind here. What I have are these grass plants here. They're called Mondo grass. They're used very commonly in landscaping because they're hardy and they kind of bush out. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna place it directly in there in its pot. And that way when the Ackie is burrowing, it'll just hit the pot and it won't like uproot the plant. I'm also gonna plant this one up against the corner to also reduce kind of the destruction of the plant. And hopefully this plant does okay in there. If not, it'll be easy to replace because I can just remove the plant and put a new one in its place in the pot. Also, this plant did go through quarantine. I completely also rinsed the roots and it got replanted with the similar mix. It's the same soil that I used in here, just without the sand. So this plant is in the same exact stuff as what's in here, so it's all still safe for the future monitor. Does it look good so far? So we have grass up front, grass in the back, we have the water dish here, and we have these two really deep log hides. So again, this one is kind of like the naturalistic moist hide. As you can see, it sticks up pretty high compared to the rest of the soil, and I did fill it to the top of that circle there. So that's probably at least a foot of soil, and it'll help hold moisture, so this one is good as well. Next, I'm gonna go ahead and do the basking spot because I wanna make sure I have enough room for that, and then I'll add in some of these extra log decorations to kind of crisscross and provide some hiding spaces. All right, so I swear I hit record, but apparently not because I just looked at my camera and it's not recording. So let me just update you on what I just did. So essentially I made a REIT stack or ready stack. And typically these are made from wood. So what you would see here is like plywood kind of 2x4 stack type thing. And that's all fine and good. But the thing is that I wanted to make this out of stone. Stone just helps kind of wear nails down. It helps hold heat as well. So I used like garden bricks and then slate tile from the hardware store. And I used bricks, tile. So mine essentially has three levels. There's one on the very, very bottom. There's this mid level right here where my hand is kind of hidden. And then there's the top level. All right guys, so that's pretty much it. I have a basking zone, which I'm gonna work on bulbs for, but that's done. Nice deep soil all along the bottom here, the very minimum being 6 inches worth of soil. And at the deepest points, way back in those logs and where we've kind of pushed everything and piled it up, definitely a foot's worth. It does look a little plain over here, I will admit, compared to this side. So if you look, like, this is all like nice and full and crazy. And then this is just a basking spot with like two logs. So I'm definitely gonna think of something to put over here just to spruce it up a little. I might add just some fake plants. But otherwise, I don't think I'll add any more real ones until I can kind of figure out if these work. And I think those will be plenty. Okay, so the last thing I wanted to do is also go ahead and measure the UV output. Again, this is my first time mounting lights inside. I have the Arcadia Pro T5 12%. So I'm gonna use a solar meter to do that. I'm gonna go grab it, but at the bottom of the screen, I'll put some details and I'll link a solar meter in the description. These are very important if you keep reptiles, especially a lot of them, and they are pretty expensive, but that's why I did splurge on one, because I have so many reptiles, and in the end it'll save me money, because in general you're supposed to replace your UV lights every, you know, once per year, but I might be able to extend kind of the lifespan because I can use my UV measure, you use my UV meter to actually see if it's time to change it or not. Okay guys, that is the final steps for building my Ackie Monitor enclosure. I can't wait till it arrives. Thank you for following along and watching. I tried my very best after months and months of research to hit all the points of having deep substrate, moist substrate, nice hot basking temps, nice airflow, you know, providing enrichment through logs and live plants and plenty of hides and all kinds of things. So the only thing left is to get the Ackie and again, my two heat bulbs, but I can figure that out pretty easily. And so everything is here, everything is done. And again, if you want to know how I made the background, which has some ledges, by the way, if you want to know how I made the background, you can watch the video that I linked below. It's the desert background, but it's the same process, just different colors. As well as I will also link the unboxing when I got it. If you like this stuff, guys, please subscribe. I do post every Friday and I look forward to seeing you all again soon. Bye.